of 7, we actually had a brain tumor removed at Red Cross Hospital. And straight after that, he had to fly off to London because he had stenosis to both his kidneys. He had 3 operations in London. He came back. And throughout his life, he just had to keep on having operations. The disease is. The disease neurofibromatosis results in growth on nerves. And it is not a terminal disease, but it can lead to a lot of suffering. He had huge lumps, big lumps on his head. You know, he had so many operations, and when he got to the age of 26, he just said to us, he was our only child, and he just said to us, he can't carry on with the operations. He's had enough. So one day he came to my husband, he was our only child, he came to my husband and I, we were sitting in the family room, and he said to us that he's found his peace. So we said, what are you talking about? And he said, no, he wants to go to Dignitas in Switzerland. That had assisted suicide and he wanted to die. He decided to get out of his and he said we would go with him. We had to see lawyers, senior counsel, because you're not allowed to assist somebody like that. You can't pay for the ticket or anything, because if you do that, you can be had up. And I'll never forget him sitting on our bed and phoning Dignitas in Switzerland and begging them to please let him come. Because he couldn't take it anymore. And they said, no, not yet, you've got to go for more operations. And he just eventually said to us, no, I can't carry on anymore. I cannot carry on. I'm going to do it myself. And we tried the first time, it took far more than what should have taken. It didn't succeed. And that is the worst, when you try and you don't succeed. And then he found a book on the internet that tells you how you can do it. And so eventually it's 2 tablets and he had to get 2 plastic bags. And recently he was able to. And that is why I believe so much. South African laws change each and there are people that are suffering to be able to die with dignity.